Okay, so welcome to our next topic. So, pag-usapan natin ngayon, lesson will be the relationship of load, shear, and bending moment in constructing the shear and bending moment diagrams of beams. I just have to explain this because we will need this one in the analysis of determinate planes. We'll also discuss yung qualitative deflected shape or mas kilala bilang elastic curve sa beams. So, yung QDS or qualitative deflected shape emphasize the curvature of the member when it is subject to loads. So, ito yung parang deflection niya, okay, yung curve load. Okay. So, by definition, the QDS is it's simply the exaggeration of the deformation of the member when loading supplied. We'll just have to see to it yung positive bending and negative bending curvatures. For positive bending, when load is applied and it produces positive bending, let's say ito yung beam natin, and na-exage lang, when a positive bending is applied to a member, yung let's say ito yung neutral axis natin, the neutral axis or yung beam cross section natin, kanya yung cross section, medyo pangit. Let's say ito yung cross section natin. And then we have here the neutral axis. The section of the beam will experience two different stresses. We have for positive bending, the upper fiber of the cross section of the beam will be under compression, and then the bottom portion will be under tension. Okay? So for positive bending, the top portion of the beam or the top portion of the cross section will experience compression, and then the bottom will be experiencing tension due to this curvature. Now for a negative deformation, the top portion will be in tension, and then the bottom portion will be in compression. Okay. So, remember this concavity, although this is just an exaggeration, because we need that in the drawing the QDS. Okay, let's say, let's take a look at this example. Let's say when load, if this is your load diagram, and this will be your bending diagram, the the sketch of the QDS, or the sketch of the elastic curve, or the qualitative deflected shape of this member when this load is applied, will be like this. So, how come? Now, notice that we have a positive bending here. So, positive bending, the behavior or the curvature of the beam should be like this. Although, this is just an exaggeration. So, it follows na ito, magka-curve siya. Okay? Yung concavity niya will be opening upward. Okay? So, magbe-bend siya ng ganito. So, meaning, because this is positive, the section of this beam, let's say this, if this is the section, let's say rectangular siya, the top portion for this segment, the top portion will be in compression and the bottom portion will be in tension. Okay, so that's why yung curvature nito is pa ganito. Now, how about in this part? Okay, how about in this part? Notice that we have a negative bending here. So the negative bending will be, it will follow this curvature. And then, contrary to the first segment, if this is the cross section, the top portion now will be in tension, and the bottom portion will be in compression. Okay? Why is it important to determine what part, particular section of the beam is in tension and in compression? Because in reinforced concrete design, you need to determine where is the what specific part of the beam is in tension, because that's where you're going to place your tension reinforcement. Okay, because in reinforced concrete, just hindi basta-basta ilalagay mo lang yung mga bakal kung saan. Kasi kung inilagay mo siya in wrong position, that reinforcement is useless when these loads is applied. So that's why some bars we call this a tension reinforcement, because they are provided on the tension side. Okay, so we'll have other examples how you draw the QDS or qualitative deflected shapes. Okay, before that, we're going to derive the relationship of load shear and bending moment, and how this affect how loads shear and how loads affect the shear diagram, and how the shear diagram affect the bending moment diagram. Okay, so in this derivation, we'll consider three different loadings. We have a uniform load, as represented by W. We have a concentrated load, P, and a concentrated couple. Okay, let's start with the concentrated load. Let's say I'm going to just get a tiny part of this uniform load with a width of dx, and then we're going to expose some of the internal reactions. Okay, the internal reactions at let's say this is A and this is B. Okay, from the left side we have, let's say we have a positive moment and shear, and then we have another moment and shear at the other side, and then let's say the length of this strip is dx, and then the load will be W. Okay, let's say we're going to apply summation forces vertical or summation forces Y, we can develop we will develop the shear relation. So we have SV represents the shear, we have positive, plus considering the right section, so we have a sign convention that upward forces will have a positive shear. So we have S plus, since this is upward, we consider that as positive. kunin mo lang yung resultant nito, which is W multiplied by the length here, which is the dx. Okay? And then minus this magnitude, which is S plus dx. And then equate that to zero. And then we're going to combine like terms. So, the simplified version of this equation will be dS is equal to W dx. And then if you're going to rearrange that, dS over dx, which is dS over dx represent, okay, this dS over dx represent the slope of your shear diagram. So the slope of your shear diagram will be the intensity of the distributed load. Let's say we're going to determine how the changes of how will be the change in shear between point A to point B considering a uniform load. Okay, if we're going to determine the change in shear from point A to point B, just have to subtract the shear at B minus the shear at A. Or, in short, determine the or get the integral of our previous slope of the shear diagram. Okay, we have the change in shear between points A and B will be the area. Since integral is, kukunin mo lang yung individual area ng strip, but we need limits para ma-determine yung specific point, which is represented by A and B. So meaning, if you're going to determine the change in shear from A to B, kukunin mo yung shear sa A plus yung plus or minus yung area dito. Ito yung area dyan, which is represented by yung area nito from A to B. That will be the change in shear. So the shear at B will be shear at A plus the change in shear of point A and point B. So how about the moment? Okay, considering the moment, let's say we're going to take moment at A, clockwise to be positive, so we have M, and we have negative, the moment produced by this uniform load, A plus, and then, now if you're going to rearrange that and combine the similar terms, makukuha mo to. Okay, this relation. So, ibig sabihin nito, the slope of the moment diagram is the shear at that specific point. And then, kapag kukunin mo naman yung change in moment from two specific points, let's say A and B, kunin mo lang yung similar, pares lang siya dito. Okay? So, the change in bending moment will be the area of the shear diagram. Pares lang sa computation dito. Okay, how about if you have a concentrated force? Mag-iba ngayon ipag merong concentrated force because we need to evaluate yung shear. Because of this concentrated, there will be two different shear at point C. So we need to evaluate the shear at left of C and right of C. Okay, let's say summation forces Y. We're going to consider this diagram. We have S plus P minus S plus DS is equal to 0. Okay, we have DS is equal to P. Okay, So this means that the change in shear at that point of the application of the concentrated load is the magnitude of this load. So ibig sabihin, if you draw the shear diagram, yung change in shear from C left to C right will be the magnitude of this load. And then for concentrated moment naman, ganun din, similar derivations. The change in bending moment at that point of application of the couple, let's say we have, since we have a concentrated moment here, we'll evaluate the moment at D left and D right. For example, this is your D. We're going to evaluate the moment at left of D and right of D. And then the change in bending moment, of, since because meron tayong concentrated load dito, the change in bending moment due to this concentrated load will be the magnitude. So the change in moment of D left and D right will be equal to the magnitude of the concentrated load. Okay? So, pang warm up lang, let's solve equation or example number 1. So number 1, okay, so unahin natin yung reactions. So let's say yun yung reaction. So kaya nyo na to. So compute the reactions. Pwede mo baklasin yan, but dito na lang natin ko-consider. So considering segment BCD, since di naman natin kailangan yung reaction sa D na hinge, so magmo-moment ako sa B, pero considering BCD lang. So summation moment at B, this will be your equation. And CY will be 250. And next, okay, we're going to consider the whole structure kasi alam na natin yung CY. Take moment at A. So take moment at A, masolve natin yung MA. So MA will be 500. And since alam mo na yung MA, pwede ka nang mag-moment, pwede consider na lang natin tong AB. Okay? We take moment at B, considering member AB only. So we'll consider taking moment at B. So, ang papasok dyan is yung AY and then yung concentrated moment MA. So, MA 50. Okay, so, alam mo na yung mga moment or reactions. After after makuha yung reactions, kunin natin yung specific shear at the specific points. So, sa evaluation of the shear using this method, you need to identify where there's a change in loading. So, change in loading, meron tayong concentrated dito. So, there will be two values of shear point A. We have A right, and shear at A right, and shear sa A A left, and A right. Since meron tayong concentrated dito. Okay? So, yung A left will be, of course, 0 yun. Yung A right will be, kasi meron tayong concentrated dito. So, the change in shear due to the concentrated load will be the magnitude of the load at that point, which is 50. So, 0 plus 50. Okay, yung A right will be 50. Next, since wala namang load dito, walang concentrated or walang vertical load, walang any load along vertical, so, yung B, point B natin, there will be one singular value of shear at B. So, VB will be 50. So, paano nakuha yan? So, VB is shear from the previous point, which is 50, plus or minus yung load in between AB. Wala namang load in between AB, kaya 0 to. So, VB will be 50. Okay, next. At C, we have a concentrated load of 250. So, there will be two values of shear at C. We have shear at C left and shear at C right. So, we need to evaluate that. So, the shear at C left will be from 50, load from the previous, shear from the previous point, which is 50, plus or minus, so minus because we have a downward force of 20 kN per meter. So minus 20 times 10. So the shear at left of C will be negative 150. And then the right of C will be the shear from the previous point, which is negative 150, plus the magnitude of the concentrated load na 250. Okay, the shear at C right will be 100. Okay, next. We have also a concentrated load at D. So, there will be two values of shear at D. We have D left and D right. So, from D left, it will be the shear from the previous point, which is 100. Since there will be no load here, kaya 100 kN lang to. And then, right of D will be shear from the previous point, which is D left, 100, minus the concentrated load. So, the shear at this point, left of, right of D will be 0. Then you can now draw the shear diagram using these values. Okay, so start with 0. And then we have 50 here. We have, since there is no load here, so a line will represent that no load is in between A and B. So we have constant load, so shear natin dito will be 50. And then from 50, it will go down to negative 150. And then from negative 150, it will go up to 100. Okay? Ito yung sinasabi kanina na change in shear when you have a concentrated load. So yung magnitude nito, yung change in shear under a concentrated load is the magnitude of the load itself. We have the 250. So yung magnitude dapat nito will be 250. Okay, you can do that by representation. We have 100 plus 150 is actually 250. Okay? So from 100, since walang load dito, constant lang yon, 100. And then from positive 100, ibababa siya ng 100 kN dito. So magiging zero siya dito. Next. Okay, determine the bending moment at specific points. So kunin natin yung moment at each specific points. But before that, kunin muna natin tong dimension na to. So ano yun? Let's say x yan. So using ratio and proportion, we can determine x. So x will be 2.5 meters. Okay? So we have a concentrated moment here. So we need to evaluate moment at A left and moment at A right. Moment at A left will be 0. And A right is moment from the previous point, which is 0. And then plus or minus the concentrated moment. So this 500 here will be negative because it's counterclockwise. So moment at A right will be negative 500. Okay? So moment at B. We have no concentrated moment at B. So there will be one unique value of moment at B, at C, and at D. So moment at B will be moment from the previous point, which is negative 500, plus or minus the area of the shear diagram from point A to point B. Okay? Yung area ng shear diagram is a rectangle. So the area will be 50 times 10. So 500 plus the product of this 50 times 1 times 10 is 500. So the moment of B will be 0. It's only valid because we have internal hinge at B. And when we say internal hinge, there's no rotation resistance. So the moment at B should always be 0. So tama to. Okay? Next, let's say the moment at point O. We need to capture the moment here at point O because this is the inflection point. So there will be a change in curvature at this point. So the moment at that point is from the previous point, which is at B. So moment at O will be moment from the previous point, 0. And then we have a positive area here, so plus 1 half 50 times 2.5. And equate that to, the result will be 62.5. Okay, how about at point C? Point C, we have 62.5. Okay, the change in moment or the moment at point C will be the moment at point B plus or minus the change in moment from B to C. From O to C, sorry. So from the previous point na 62.5, we're going to subtract the area of the shear diagram, which is negative. So negative 1 half, 150 times 7.5. So equals negative 500. Okay? And then the moment at D will be moment from the previous point, which is 500 kN meter, plus yung area. Because we have a positive shear area here. So positive 100 times 5 is 0. And after that, you cannot draw your moment diagram. So from 0, okay, bababa tayo ng negative 500. And then from negative 500, we'll go back to 0 at point B. And then from 0, it will go up to 62.5. And then from 62.5, it will go down again to negative 500. And then from negative 500, it will go back to 0. Okay. So from this diagram, kung saan yung sabi kasi, most of the time sabi kasi nila, kung saan yung zero shear, nandun yung maximum moment. Hindi lagi yon. Okay? Notice na nandito yung zero shear. Yes, nandito yung zero shear. Pero hindi yan yung maximum moment. Ang maximum moment is 500. So it's not always that the maximum moment will occur on the zero shear. Ang correct explanation dun is, sa zero shear nag-a-act yung change in or the zero shear only represent the maximum moment at that specific point, at that specific segment only. Not true to all or not true to the whole structure. So, dito lang na segment yon. Yes, positive siya for this segment. Okay? So, it represents only the inflection point. So, merong change in curvature. So, from positive curvature, mag-negative curvature. So, yun. And of course, yung last, draw natin yung QDS or qualitative deflected shape. So, magagaling yon based dito sa moment diagram natin. Okay, since internal hinge to, internal hinge, so there will be rotation. So, pwedeng mag-displace yan. So, pwedeng bumaba, pwedeng tumaas. Depende sa moment. So, ito yung moment natin, positive, ay negative, sorry. So, pag negative bending, yung curvature will be, alam yan. Okay, so that's why yung curve natin dito, from A to B, ang curvature niya is, pag ganito, okay, merong sad face dito. And then, we have a positive bending here. So, yung positive bending natin, yung positive bending, yung curvature naman dito, is, ganyan. Kasi tension. So, dapat yung curvature, basta ma-emphasize mo lang yung parang behavior. And then, we have again, a negative bending here. So, ito, itong beam segment na to, pag bibend siya, yung curvature niya, because of this negative bending, ganito rin. So, ito ngayon yung curvature ng beam natin. Sundan niya lang yung laser. So, ito yun. So, ito yung curvature niya ngayon. Okay? So, madali ang itong method na to using the relationship kapag meron kang mga malitong loadings lang. Okay? Naging mahirap lang siya if you have this kind of loading diagram. Okay. Paano naman i-apply yung shear and bending moment, yung relation ng load, shear, and bending moment diagram? So, paano mo i-construct ngayon yung shear and bending moment diagram using the method discussed above? So, medyo mas complicated lang to. Pero just to represent yung paano gamitin yung method na to. So, I'll start with the support reaction. So, we have AY here and then BY. So, let's say hatiin ko itong trapezoid into two different loadings. We have a rectangular na 15 and then we have a triangular na ito. So, yung resultant ng yung rectangular load na 15 or throughout the 9 meter length will be 135. And then, dito naman sa rectangular load, ay triangular load, is 101.25. Okay? Kunin mo lang yung area nito, nung triangle na ito. So, yung triangle na yan is 1/2 9 times ito, pag subtractin lang to. Okay, so summation moment at B, result for A. AY will be 33.75. Then, summation moment at A to solve for B, BY. BY will be 202.5. Okay? So, next, draw the shear diagram using the load diagram. So, at point A, we have A left and A right. So, A left will be 0. A right will be 0 plus the magnitude of the concentrated load. So, 33.75. And then at point B, we have also concentrated load at 202, so we're going to evaluate the shear at B left and shear at B right. Okay, VB left will be 33.75 minus yung area of the trapezoid. Okay, from point A to point B. Trapezoid yun, kasi we have, so yung intensity ng load dito sa point B, kung mag-relation proportion ka, will be 30 kN. Per meter dapat to. Okay, okay, lagyan ng, should be, kilonewton per meter. Pangit. Palitan ko lang. Okay, so if you're going to ito, 30 kilonewton per meter dapat to. Okay, at nyan, 30 kilonewton per meter. Okay, so VB left will be shear from the previous point, which is 33.75 minus the area of the load diagram. So from 15 to 30, trapezoid to. So, minus, okay, if base 1, we have the base 1, ito yung trapezoid natin. So, area nun is 15 plus 30 over 2 times yung length na 6. Okay, yung shear dun, left of C, left of B is 101, negative 101.25. And then, right of B will be from the previous point, which is 101.25 plus 202.5. It will give you 101.25. And then, we have a point C, We have no concentrated load C, so isa lang yung shear sa C. So VC will be shear from the previous point, which is 101.25, minus yung load diagram, or yung area ng load between B to C. So trapezoid din to, so 30 plus 37.5 divided by 2 times 3. So yung shear doon will be 0. Okay? So, draw mo lang yung shear diagram. So from 0, tataas siya ng 33.75. And then from 33.75, bababa to 101.25. Take note, we have a first degree line here. Ito dapat to connect 33 and 101 should be represented by a second degree curve. And then from 101, tataas siya to 101.25. The change in shear due to this concentrated load from this point to this point is equal to 202.5. Okay? And then from 101.25, pupunta siya ng 0. Okay, to connect that, dapat second degree curve din. Okay? So, yung second degree curve na yan, ito yan. Okay, okay lang sa shear diagram, yung pagkuha. Pero magiging complicated yan sa pagkuha ng moment diagram. Okay? Before that, explain ko lang. Ito, this is the shape of a parabola. Ito naman, this is a parabola. Ito naman, is a parabolic spandrel. This area. Ito parabola, ito parabolic spandrel. Ito naman, parabola. Okay, before we proceed to the computation, I'll just explain this one. So we have, kanina, meron tayong parabola and a parabolic segment. Okay, so for parabolic segment, actually, yung composition ng parabolic segment and parabolic curve, ay parabolic parabola and a parabolic segment, it's actually, kapag pinagsama mo yun, it's actually a rectangle. Okay? Dito na lang. Pag pinagsama mo to, itong dalawa, parabola, parabolic spandrel and quadrant of parabola, actually mabubuo kang let's say ito yung vertex parabola. Yan. Ito yung parabola. Ito naman yung spandrel, parabolic spandrel. Pag pinagsama mo yung area na yan, dapat area ng, let's say ito yung base, and ito yung height. So pag kinuha mo yung spandrel, pinagsama mo itong area ng dalawa, should be base times height. So, let's say ito yung parabolic spandrel, which is ito. And then, itong parabola naman, ito. So, the area of the parabolic spandrel, ito yon, is base times height or 1/3 base times height. And then, for the parabola, is 2/3 base times height. Notice that when you combine these two area, so, base BH over 3 plus 2/3 BH over 3, it will give you the area of a rectangle, which is base times height. Okay? So, pag spandrel, ang area natin is base times height over 3. And then, pag parabola, is 2/3 base times height. Okay? Ano ba yung base natin? Yung base natin, ito, if this is the vertex of the parabola, ito yung base, ito yung height. Pag spandrel naman, ito yung vertex, ito yung base, ito yung height. Okay? Okay, balik tayo dito. Kaya lang, ito, hindi kasi vertex point to. Yung A. Kasi may magnitude dyan, hindi zero yung load dyan. So, kailangan natin kunin kung saan magzi-zero yung load. So, magzi-zero yung load na yon dito. Extend lang natin to. Yan, extend. Pag in-extend mo yan, ito yung vertex natin. Ito yung vertex. Okay, once you establish the vertex, pwede mo nang, okay, ito yung shear diagram natin kanina. Let's say ito yung, okay, next. Okay, ito yung vertex natin. So, kailangan natin, nakuha na pala natin kanina. So, let's say ito yung mga area 1 natin ng shear diagram rin, ha. Let's say, consider natin area 1 to, area 2, and area 3. Okay? You cannot just apply Yung sis parabola to, baka isipin nyo, pwede nang i-apply yung 2/3 base times height. Take note, hindi mo pwedeng i-apply yon kasi hindi mo pa na-establish yung vertex. So, dapat ang reference line mo will always come from the vertex. So, ito yung vertex point natin. Ito yung vertex point. So, dapat lahat ng dimensions mo magmumula dyan. Okay? So, una, first step is extend natin to and then solve for A. Okay, pag na, so, para masolve mo yung A, ratio and proportion, so, A is to 15 and then A plus 9, kasi ito, is to 37.5. So, makukuha mo yung value ng A will be 6 meters. So, from point A, idarag tayo ng 6 meters to the left para ma-determine natin yung vertex. And then, from the vertex point, pwede na natin, ito yung curve natin, pwede na natin i-extend to this point. Okay, pag na-extend mo na yan, you can now determine Y1. Yung Y1 na yan is actually the area of this small triangle. Okay, itong triangle na nabuo dito. So, yung area na yon is 1 half, 6 times 15. So, yung Y1 will be 45 kN meter. Ito yung magnitude na to. Okay? So, the total from this point naman okay, from this point hanggang dito is Y1 plus 33.75. Okay? So, paano ngayon paano mo ngayon makukuha yung A1? So, yung A1, before that, kailangan natin yung X1. So, para masolve yung X1, remember from the square property of parabola. So, ano ba yung parabola natin dito? So, we have here the vertex. We have a parabola that opens downward. So, ito yung parabola na magbubuo mo yan. Yan. Ganyan. Kailangan talaga ko-consider natin. So, yung square property of parabola, which is y is equal to kx, let's say constant proportionality natin yung k, or yung a na to, yung magnitude na yan. So, represent natin yan, k is equal to x squared over 1. So, using the square property of parabola, makukuha mo yung x1. That is, so from this relation, we have x represent the horizontal distance, and y represents the vertical magnitude. So, we have a squared. Ito, a squared is to y1, which is itong horizontal na to, this parabola, ratio and proportion natin, with respect to this big parabola. Okay? So, yung a squared all over y1, ito yun yung small parabola na to. And then, we have this relation, yung big parabola is from this point, ito yung big parabola naman na relation natin. Okay, nakikita nyo malaki. Sundan nyo lang yung cursor. So, yung parabola na yan will be, yung x distance will be a plus x1. A plus x1. And squared mo yan. And then, the magnitude of the vertical distance will be y1 plus 33.75. Okay, substitute mo lang para makuha mo. Ang unknown lang dyan is x1. Okay, shift solve. x1 will be 1.94. Okay, so, pan-solve mo na yung 1.94. Okay. Take note, huwag kang excited, you cannot immediately use this formula. Bakit hindi pwede? Okay? Baka kasi isipin nyo, apply immediately the formula for this parabola. Hindi pwede yon. Kasi nga, hindi ito yung vertex. So, yung ganun dapat natin, yung solution ng area, dapat mag-refer yan sa vertex. Dito dapat tayo mag-refer. So, paano mo kuha yung area 1? So, yung area 1 is considering this malaking parabola, parabolic segment, to, para makuha mo yung A1 is this parabola minus this area, tong area na to. Okay. Yung light blue represents yung big parabola, which is ito. Yun yung area. Okay? And then, tatanggalin natin to. Pag tinanggal mo tong area na yan, makukuha mo yung A1. So, paano mo makukuha yun? Erase ko muna to. Okay? Paano makukuha yun? So, ito, this parabola, paano makukuha yung area niyan? So, yung parabola na yan will be 2/3 base times height. So, 2/3 of 7.94. Saan nakuha yung 7.94? 6 plus 1.94. So, total base times height. Yung height nito is ito. So, Y1 plus 33.75. So, 45 plus 33.75, 78.75. Okay, next. Ito yung big parabola. Kailangan natin minus yung small parabola, which is yung yellow. Okay, ito yung small parabola naman. Okay, minus kasi hindi natin kailangan. Ito lang kailangan natin A1. So, again, two-third base. Two-third base times height. Okay, two-third of 6 to times yung Y1, which is 45. And then, minus yung ito na lang. Minus yung itong rectangle dito. Okay, yung rectangle na yan is 6 times 33.75. Makuha mo na ngayon yung A1. So, A1 will be 34.35. Okay, next. Yung A2 muna, how will you get A2? So, yung A2 is from the pig, makikita mo naman yung figure ng spandrel. Ito yung spandrel. Oh, wait lang, medyo pangit-pangit. Okay, ito yung spandrel na malaki. Okay, kung nakikita nyo. Ito naman yung generic. Ito. Yan, yung spandrel na yan. So, ito lang yung kailangan natin. I-shade ko lang yung red. Okay, shade ko lang red. Ito lang yung kailangan natin. This area. So, paano makukuha yan? So, it will be, click tayo dito sa formula ng spandrel. So, one-third base times height. Ganun din. So, reference natin this vertex. So, one-third nung spandrel na malaki, which is, ito, 78 to, ito naman 101, tama? So, 101 yan. So, yung total distance or total magnitude or altitude ng spandrel, parabolic spandrel is 180. So, 180 times 12. So, paano yung 12 yun? Kung 6 meters to, from A to B, 6 meters din. So, 12 yun. And then, minus yung maliit na spandrel. So, saan yung maliit na spandrel? Ito naman yung maliit na spandrel. Ito yung maliit na spandrel. So, spandrel na yun, one-third din. Okay, yung base nun is 7.94. So, from A plus X1. So, 7.94. Yung A natin kanina is 6. Yung X1 is 1.94. Kaya 7.94 to. And then, yung yung height nito, yung spandrel na ito is 78.75. Okay? And then minus itong triangle. So, nakikita nyo yung triangle. Ito naman yung triangle. Yan. So, yung triangle is 4.06 times 78.78. So, yung area 2 is 191.85. Sir, hindi ba pwedeng i-diretso na lang ng one-third to? One-third base times height? Hindi pwede. Kasi hindi naman to yung vertex. Hindi naman nandyan yung vertex. Nandito yung vertex. Okay? That's why, tinuro ko muna yung equation bago to. Okay? So that you can appreciate kung ano yung mas maganda gamitin when you're dealing with this type of loading. Kung equation ba or gamitin yung area method. Okay? So next, yung A3. Okay? Yung A3 naman is parabola ulit. Okay? Parabola ulit itong A3. Pero i-drawing ko na lang dito. Let's say ito yung vertex point natin kanina. Ito yung vertex point. Ito yung V natin, vertex point sa parabola, which is ito. So, let's say extend ko. Ito lang yung area na kailangan natin. Okay, yung area 3. Pero yung area 3 layout, pag in-extend ko to, alam mo ito, 101.25. Pag in-extend natin yan, yung magnitude ng extension na to, from this point hanggang doon, will be yung area ng triangle. Itong triangle lang na to. Okay, gaya kanina yung ginawa natin. Kasi dito tayo nag-start eh. So, width will be 1 half 12 kasi 6 plus 6 and then times 30, ano yung magnitude dito? So, yung magnitude na to, ito lang ha, is 180. Okay? So, yung total nito, 180 plus 101, 25 kung kukunin mo tong total magnitude dito. So, let's say C yan. Yung C is sum of 180 and 101.25. Okay? So, pwede nang kunin yan. So, yung area 3, area 3, A3 to ah. Okay? A3 will be area of the big parabola. Okay, area ng big parabola. Ito. Yan. Yung area ng big parabola, which is 2/3 of base times height. 2/3. So, 6, 6, 3. So, 2/3 base, which is 15, times height, is etong C. Yung height dito is 180 plus 101.25. So, it will give you 281.25. And then, minus yung small parabola dito. So, saan yung small parabola? Ito yung small parabola. Yan. So, yung small parabola will be 2/3 base, 12, times height. Yung magnitude lang nito, 180. And then, minus itong rectangle dyan. So, yung rectangle, ito yun. Yan, yung rectangle na yan. So, makukuha mo na yung A3. A3 will be 157.5 kN. Okay? So, drawing ko lang ulit. Ito yung A1, 34.35. Ito naman, 191. Ito, 157.5. So, you cannot draw your moment diagram. So, moment diagram at point A, walang concentrated moment doon. So, moment A, isa lang yung moment sa A, which is 0. Okay, kailangan lang natin to, yung 1.94. So, we need to capture yung moment from 1.94 from point A. So, it will be, so, moment at 1.94, it will be moment from the previous point, which is 0, plus, kasi positive shear to, yung area 1. So, yung area 1 is 34.35. Equal to 34.35 kN. And then, at point B, so moment from the previous point, which is 34.35, minus yung area nito, ng shear diagram, which is 191.85. 191.85, so negative 157.5. And then, at point C, moment from the previous point, which is negative 157.5, plus yung shear area ng shear diagram, which is 157.5. And moment at point C will be 0. Okay? So, pag meron kayong trapezoidal load, bahala kayo if you will use equation or you're going to use this method. Anyway, they will give you the same result. Now, just make sure that when you're using this method and you have a trapezoidal load, make sure you determine where the vertex or where this trapezoidal load intersect the horizontal line or kung saan yung 0. Zero magnitude. Okay? So, that's all for this topic. Next topic will be analysis and of determinate frames. So, we'll be using this method in drawing the shear moment and Q qualitative deflective. Ay, meron pa pala. Okay? So, drawing lang na shear moment, yung moment diagram. So, we have 34.35 yung magnitude dito. And then we have negative 1.7 and then from 0. And then also yung QDS. Draw the qualitative deflected shape. So, in QDS, so, drawing ko lang to. So, from this point, since positive yan, yung positive bending, magaganyan yon. And then, you have negative bending. Ay, sorry. Sorry. Okay, from... Okay, since we have positive bending here, so, yung deflection niya dapat pa ganito. Okay, pa ganyan. So, ito ngayon yung magiging deflected shape. So, ito, we have a positive bending. So, yung curvature dapat ng beam natin will be concave upward. Okay? So, yung taas dapat is under compression. Yung baba is under tension. And then, because of the negative bending here, so, magde-deflect din siya na pa ganyan. Okay? So, that's how you do the shear bending moment and qualitative deflected shape for beams using this method.